defining, excuse me. Let's do that again. Ola Henriksen. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and I'm gonna try and see if I can still film, because it's been 3 long weeks since I've sat in front of the camera to actually talk to you guys. And for those of you who follow me on Snapchat, you probably already know why. That's because I was away in Scotland for holidays with Duncan and his family. We visited his family. So I haven't actually sat down to film anything. All of the videos that you've seen from September 18th until the 4th of October would have been pre-filmed. So all of those things were done before I left. Now I'm going to talk to you guys about my September favorites, and I know it's late and I usually put this out on the last day of the month, but because I was away, I wasn't able to film that, and I didn't want to pre-film that because I would be cheating. I would have only used items for like 18 days of the month, which isn't the right thing to do. So I decided that I was going to do it even though it's late when I come back. Just a few things. There are a few videos that would be coming to you very soon, as soon as I get my rhythm back into filming. I did write down a few of them. Let me just see. What have we got in store? I'm going to be filming the fall favorites tag. I did it, I think, last year as well, but every year products change, so we're going to update that. I'm also going to be filming a UK haul right after this video, so you'll probably see me in the same getup. My hair is still wet and all that because I just got out of the shower. I'll be filming a US haul as soon as that arrives. I ordered a few things from ColourPop and e.l.f. Right now I'm filming September Hits and Shits. Then let me know if you want a Scotland vlog, because I did take a few footages while I was there. But it was really not some kind of talking video, so it would be more like a montage and a few pictures of the things that I took while I was there. Of course, I did my little photography thing while I was there. I'm going to be doing a ColourPop review as soon as my new order comes in, and an e.l.f. review as soon as that order comes in. There's also going to be... Okay, there's this thing that I'm trying out. I've already filmed the before shot, but I don't know if you want to see that. I'm struggling to lose weight. I'm not overweight by any means. I'm still within the normal range for my height. However, I do feel quite lethargic, and I'm a little concerned with the size of my midsection. So I decided I was going to jump into getting back into working out. So I wasn't sure if I was going to call it Weight Loss Wednesday, because weight loss really isn't the purpose of it, but more like to get my endurance back and my strength, because I'm losing muscle mass. So there, I'm not sure if I'm going to call it Weight Loss Wednesday or Workout Wednesday, but that's something that I'm going to be doing starting next week. And I'll show you the progress of my toning. I've started today. I did the day one of the 30-day shred by Jillian Michaels. Yes, I'll talk about that a little bit more on that actual video. Let me know if you actually want to see that. I'm going to start filming and doing it on a weekly basis. But if you don't want to see it, comment down below and I won't publish it. That's all there is to it. So let's talk about the reason why you're here. You're here to see my September hits and shits. Okay, so let's talk about first probably skincare. And I'm going to talk about this. It's in the travel container. This is my Clarisonic Mia 2. Yep. I brought this with me when I was in Scotland because, well, I always do my Clarisonic cleansing when I wear makeup. And I didn't really wear a lot while I was in Scotland, but I just wanted to make sure that my skin was cleansed. I did break out quite a bit while I was there because I felt like with the cold weather, and it was really, for me, it was really cold. I mean, having been born and grew up in a tropical country, 15 degrees in the daytime is quite cold for me. And it went down to 1 degree at some point during our holiday. So I was like, whoa. So I have oily skin. And what it felt like to me was my skin felt dehydrated, probably because I didn't sweat so much. And so I didn't really drink too much water. And then not only that, because we were traveling all the time, I felt like my sweat and the oils of my skin solidified before they got out of the pores. So I actually had a lot of whiteheads when I came back, and I did a little bit of cleaning last night, and that was ew. Too much information, I guess, for some of you guys. But yes, I did do the exfoliating and the cleansing with my Clarisonic while I was there. Another thing that I did fall in love with, on the days that I didn't wear makeup, I would just like slap on SPF, because even though it's kind of cloudy over there, the sun still gets through, and you know you have to take care of your skin. So I would slap on, what do you call this, SPF. Then I would wash off my face in the evening, and then I would follow it up with this. This is the Ola Henriksen Oil-Free Pore Refining. Excuse me. Let's do that again. Ola Henriksen Grease Relief Cleansing Cloths. These are oil-free pore refining cleansing cloths. And one side is smooth, the other side is a little bit more gritty. So if I'm not using my Clarisonic, because I only use that when I wear makeup, but if I'm not using that, I would use this to do the exfoliation. This comes in 10 cloths. I think I only have maybe 4 or 3 left inside. That's soon going to go into my empty spin. Another item that is not necessarily skincare, but something that I still loved, was the Shai or Shai, or however you pronounce it, Shai. This is a razor, and this is the kind of razor that bends with the curves of your legs. So this is what I use for my legs and my underarms while I was there, because it's just more convenient. They also come with a refill, so that's pretty good. I don't know if you can get this anywhere else. This is supposed to be a Korean brand, and I got this here in Vietnam. Not cheap either. Okay. Oh, the SPF that I was using while I was there was, of course, the Neutrogena Rapid Wrinkle Repair Moisturizer with SPF 30. So this has also got retinol to help my skin clear up. There you go. And because it's extremely cold over there, I needed the moisturizer that was going to keep my skin hydrated and moisturized. So I brought with me my Origins Drink Up Intensive. You know, I've talked about this in previous favorites videos before, and I love it. Okay, let's get on to makeup. Base. I brought my MAC Studio Fix Fluid with me while I was there, but I used it once probably, because the rest of the time I was using my MAC Studio Face and Body Foundation. I love this thing. You need to shake it up before you use it. But this is like skin, but better. So I brought this with me, and this was all that I used when I did apply makeup on. It's a light to medium coverage. You can build it up to medium, but I would say it's more of a light coverage. It looks like your skin, but it like evens out your skin tone and makes you look just beautiful. So yeah, I do like this a lot. It tends to be a little bit tacky, so I set it with powder, and the powder that I use is the MAC, excuse me, Mineralize Skin Naturals in medium. There you go. That's first makeup. Still on skin, the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfectors. I got this from the holiday collection last year. I think it was $25. I don't know if they're going to come out with another one this year. But this is in the color Champagne Gold, Pearl, and Opal. And what I do with this is I actually take one swipe of each on the back of my hand, and I mix them all together, and that's what I use to do my highlight and my sort of my strobing. If you want to see a tutorial on that, let me know and I will do that for you. But it's pretty straightforward. You just mix the three and you put it in the areas where you would like to illuminate your skin. I didn't use it today because I used a different highlighter, and I don't know if you can actually see it on camera. The highlighter that I used is from this palette, the NARS, what did you call this, virtual domination palette, and it is called Miss Liberty. That's that right there. Another one that I've been loving from this palette is the blush that I have on right now, which is the Deep Throat color right there. And I also use the Laguna bronzer here behind my cheeks, not really as a contour, but really as a bronzer. But yeah, that's what I have on my skin. I've been loving this palette. What I've been doing as well is I've been mixing these two while I was I've been mixing these two. I would use my Real Techniques brush. But what I've done lately, the look that I've been loving, is using the bronzer really just on the back of my cheeks and then popping a pinkish color on my on the apples of my cheeks. I got the idea from the Swish and Pop blush of Charlotte Tilbury, but I can't afford that blush, so I decided I was going to use the blushes that I have with the same technique that is recommended for those blushes. So that's what that is. Now, okay, eyes. What's on my eyes right now are the two things that I've been using while I was there, and these are the Tarte Smolder Eyes eyeshadow pencils. This one is in rose gold, and this one is in taupe. That's what you're seeing on my eyes right now. On the outside corner is taupe, and then in the inner half is rose gold. That's what I have there. I don't have any eyeliners on, but I did bring with me a few eyeliners. I'm going to talk about that last because they're a flop. Okay. I also did get this lip balm from Primark. I think it was £1.50. And these are Reese's. Can you see that? These are Reese's lip balm. They don't taste like peanut butter though. They taste like white chocolate. And they actually look like white chocolate as well because it's like just white. I do love this. It's a favorite because of the scent and the taste, because this is actually quite sweet, but not really as effective as I would want it for keeping my lips moisturized. Speaking of lips, the two products or two lip colors that I've been using while I was there and even while I was here, and what's on my lips right now. Every time that I would put on lipstick, it would be one of these two. This is the MAC. This is limited edition from last year, I believe. This is from their Aquatics collection. It's a cream sheen called Goddess of the Sea, and that's the lip color that I have on. There are many other colors from MAC on the permanent line that can mimic this or could dupe the color. I'm not exactly sure what they are, but I'm sure there are. Okay, and then the other one is the Estee Lauder Pure Envy lipstick in 420 Rebellious Rose, which is what that looks like. Anytime that I would put color on my lips, it's one of these two, just because they're so fall appropriate, and Scotland was way into fall when we came. Okay, now let's talk about the shits. And this is also the reason why I would never buy anything else from this brand. I've talked about this before, but I brought with me my Marc Jacobs Skyliner. This came in a little set last year during the holidays. I already talked about this. I already said in my review that I didn't like these. These don't stay on my lids. I used them as eyeliner while I was there, and they would just disappear, especially the blacker one. I don't know what's wrong with this, but this just disappears within the first 2 hours of putting them on. So what I ended up doing was actually using them for my waterline. On the lids, because I have oily lids, they just go away. But on my waterline, I have this one right here. What color is this? Sunset. I have Sunset on my waterline right now. I'll come closer so you can see that. Yeah, that's what I'm wearing right now. They work down here, but up here, no. So these are my shits, because these are expensive. I think they were like $45, or was it $40? Somewhere along those lines when I bought these last year. And I was like, oh, seven beautiful things from Marc Jacobs. And I was so unimpressed by these that it ended up just sitting on my desk. And now there's like, some of them are like literally falling off their containers. I don't know which one it was. Oh, here. Here you go. This one is Think with ink in the parentheses. This one's just like gonna come off. See? A lot of them are like that. Even Sunset was like that. Yeah, because they're drying out now. And I haven't even been able to use them quite a bit. So that's why I took this with me, just so that my $45 would not be wasted. But I wouldn't waste my money on these if you have oily lids, because they're just gonna go disappear, unless you're buying this simply for the water line. So those are my shits. Okay, and that goes across the board for all those colors. None of them work on my lash line, just on the water line. Those are my hits and my shits for the month of September. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any comments or violent reactions, please do comment down below. Now, when I say that these are hits or shits, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to apply to you as well. Some products work better for others than they do for me. In fact, I bought that Marc Jacobs thing on recommendation by so many YouTube gurus because they said that it's the best for their waterline, it's the best for their lash line, it doesn't go anywhere, but it didn't work for me. All right, so yeah, that's all I have to say. Obviously, I'm trying to get my rhythm back into filming. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you all again in my next video. Bye.